front. So you can see it's unfold. I've folded it so it's unfold. So you can also do it full, right? So which I'll be showing you in the course of this video. Okay, you can do it full like this, you still achieve it. But then I want to, you may want to sew the waist that, so you can just decide to leave it. You can decide to leave it and then to sew it if you want it fitted. But eliminating the dart, I'm not sewing the dart for the front because of the cowl. So the cowl, the fullness of the cowl is so much. Okay, it's that like this. But then when you close it like this, so you can see, so once you close it this way, you can see that this place is not as flat. Okay, it's not as flat as you want it. Okay, so now what I will be doing now, instead of closing it like this, I'll take out the dart. So my dart is 1 inch, so I'll take it out from here. So my dart is 1 inch, so this is my 1 inch. Okay, so I'll just connect it back. I'll connect it back to my bust line. Okay, so this is my bust line. Okay, so my 1 inch seam allowance, so I added 1 inch seam allowance. So I will be doing the 1 inch seam allowance from here. So this is my 1 inch seam allowance. So I've succeeded in taking out, I'll connect it back to my 1 inch seam allowance on the bust line. Okay, so I've succeeded in taking out the waist dart. So if you're working with an already made, you have a working pattern, okay, you can just eliminate it this way. But if you are drafting pattern from scratch, just do it to leave out the dart. Okay, so whichever way. So now what we have left now is our bust dart. Okay, the bust dart or underarm dart. So we also close it this way. So like I said, you close it this way, you see it will not be flat. But then because you are doing cowl, it still doesn't really matter. So you can do it this way. So because we'll still be slashing everything out, so I'm moving it to this point. Okay, all right. So what I will do now is to just cut this part. And then tape it down. Okay, so you only move your dart to your center from when you're doing a cowl dress like this. Okay, so now for now I want 4 slash lines. Okay, so now we'll be adding fullness to our shoulder, so it will be full down, right? So I'll measure my shoulder and then I've added all my seam allowances already. Okay, so this I have 5 to 8, so I'll just I want a 4 slash line, so I'll divide it into 4. So okay, connecting it. So I want 4 slash lines. This is my 4 slash lines. Remember, my fabric is still unfolded. So if I was to open it now, I'll just use my tracing wheel. I'll trace it and then I'll have it on this side and then I'll connect the lines. Okay, all right. Shoulder 1, 2, 3, 4. Labeling is very important, so you don't confuse, because you are going to cut it through. So this is my center front. Please, your center front is very, very important. You know, if it's a fabric, you cut it, you fold it like this. Okay, so this is your center front. So let's assume it's already folded. Okay, so this is it, center front. This is the fabric, so I'll place it at the tip of the fabric. Okay, so make sure it's around the tip of your fabric, assuming this is your fabric. Unfold, you come, you place it this way. Okay, now it's clear. All right, so make sure it's around the tip, so you pin it down. It shouldn't be straight anyway, so don't. So now this is where it is now, so we'll start measuring. Okay, so from here now, how many inches are you should measure for this? Okay, so now how many inch do you want it? How many inch fullness do you want? So I'll be doing, let me do 1.5. So it depends on the amount of fabric you have. Okay, so the amount of fabric you have will determine how much fullness. I'll pin this down. Okay. And then you can see my shoulder. So this shoulder like this, I'll come out and I'll connect So you can use your ruler and then you connect just for easy, so that when you are pleating, because after now, once you cut it out, you won't even know the part you added. Okay, so I add 2.5 here. Can you imagine? I didn't measure this part, so I'm drawing a straight line here from this my shoulder tip here. Can you see the straight line? So this is my shoulder tip. Okay, so this is the shoulder already. So remember, the shoulder is also do this, right? Like if you cut it straight away the way it is like this now. So if you want to do face, you can just do facing. So when, if you watch the second tutorial, the second one on this same video, if you watch to the end, you will see the way I did. The other one has facing. Okay, so what you do, you just extend and then cut your facing. All right, so you can do it like this, but that means your neck will be wide, but this one, the neck is not wide. So I want to do it a normal neck, round neck, high neck. So if you want to do a turtle neck also, so just watch what I'm doing now, so you can achieve your turtle neck this same way. We still want more fullness, we want it very very full to the very top. So I want to add more fullness. So this is my center front. So what I'll do now, depending on how much fabric you have, so I'll be doing, let me add 8 more inches. But for the main dress, I think I did 10. So this is 10. So this is 8 inches. Okay. So this is 8 inches. All right. So for the 8 inches now, so I want to measure my neckline. My neck is what? 3 inches. So 3 by 3. So I'll add seam allowance from this neckline. You are connecting it straight to the shoulder. You are not adding shoulder, so it's like this is another shoulder. So we are extending. I don't know if you can see this. So this is my neckline, and then this is my shoulder. So at the end of everything, now when I'm cutting, I will cut this way. So that's why you need a lot of fabric. So you cut, then you can just add seam allowance. I've already added seam allowance here already on the main shoulder. Okay, so that means the seam allowance, this is the main shoulder, this is the seam allowance. So that means seam allowance is already added. Okay, so don't restrict yourself. Okay, so this is also what I'm doing now. This part, what I'll do is I'll flip this part back to the original shoulder, then all these parts will go inside. Now the way it is right now, the way it is like this now, if I want to do a turtle neck, I'll leave it like this. What I'll do now, I'll measure this part. So if you want to do a closely fitted turtle neck, I also have a tutorial like this. I have a tutorial on it already, so I'll pin it and I'll drop it in the description box. Okay, you can see I have 3.6368. Okay, so this 368. So this 368 now divide by 2. So this 7. This is 768. So this is just half part, and then this the second part of this. So you have 2, and then this measurement, you now get your back measurement. So this is the back now. So the back also, I've also removed the waist. You can decide to remove the waist that, but because it's fitted, mine has, I didn't take off the waist that, I sew it. Okay, so now what you do now, you take your back neck also, you measure. Okay, so what you have, I also have 3 to 8. Add this and this together. So that's what you use to cut your neckline, your turtle neck. Okay, yes, you can do a turtle neck, but I'm not doing a turtle neck for this. I already have a tutorial on how to do a turtle neck. So I'm cutting a facing. So the facing, I'll cut from here to this part like this. So this will be my facing, okay, for the front. But if you are doing a turtle neck, you don't have to cut the facing. You just measure this, measure the back neck. This is the fabric. But it's just that my own fabric is not long. So if you are using a main fabric now, you know it would have extended down. So you will now cut. So your waist won't be straight. It will be slanted like this. Okay, so this is how you, so at the end of everything, you pleat everything. So back will be a guide. So if you want to do it open, so I'll be showing you on the fabric now, but this time it's not on fold, it's full front. Okay, so two ways, anyhow you want it, you can always achieve a cowl neck. So now for this is half unfold. So I'll be showing you on how to cut on the fabric full front, okay? So don't forget to like this video, please. This video is well packed. Watch to the end, like I said, so you see the other without waist seam. So assuming we are still doing a normal dress, so remember the way I slashed. So this is what we have. So I will go to my machine now. I will go and sew and trim off these excesses and the back together. Okay, so I ironed this tape because I don't want the zip to fold, to have a fold around the back area. So now you can see that the front is way bigger because of the way we spread. Okay, but it doesn't matter, it will all add to the fullness. Where you want to be fitted is your waist area. Okay, so just make sure your bust, so you can see that this part is bigger. So what you need to do is just make sure that the waist is aligning. Okay, so it doesn't matter even if you have it bigger around the bust side. So the front will be way bigger because of the spread. Okay, so we'll just make sure the waist, use your actual measurements for the waist. So I will sew my actual measurement on the waist side. And ladies and gentlemen, so this is what we have. I fixed my sleeve. This is the pattern I'm using. So if you're a freehand person, you don't have to worry. So you can actually do this freehand, right? So but I chose to use my pattern, right, to show you, so that for those that don't do freehand, that are strictly pattern drafters, they will also get along. So but if you do pattern and you do freehand at the same time, you can just do your normal ways, that you can just draft your bodies normal without any dart around the waist side, and just get your normal measurements. That's if you want it free. But if you want it fitted, then you can do with the dart. Okay, so you can sew the dart. So but this, I won't be sewing the dart. I'll be eliminating the armhole dart, the underarm dart, that's the bust dart, and then the waist dart. So I'll be showing you how to do that. So for the waist dart, if you've been following my tutorials, you know that I have a simple way to eliminate the waist dart. So my dart here is 1 inch. Okay, so how to draft the bodies, I have a tutorial on how to draft basic bodies. Okay, so this is my 1 inch here. Measure my seam allowance. My seam allowance here is 1 inch. Yes, the fabric is a bit stretchy. I don't want it fitted. I don't want it closely fitted. Okay, so but if you want it straight, not you don't want any fit at all, you can just go ahead and cut. But because I still want a little bit of shape around it, okay, so I'll be replacing my 1 inch. I'll be putting my 1 inch seam allowance. Okay, so around the hip here, the seam allowance is already here. So this is the seam allowance. So from here, so this is my seam allowance. So from this seam allowance, I'll connect it back to my hip line. This is now my waist dart. This dart that I eliminated, this waist dart here now is already here. So what I'll do now is to cut it out. Okay. So I want to close this dart, and I just want to move it here. Patch this part open. And then my dart transfer now. I'll pin the video to my dart transfer, so you know how to transfer your dart to any part of the body. Yes, if you've been following me, you know you can move your dart to any part of your body. You can see I've successfully closed my dart. You can see the dart is now here. So now I'll tape it down. For those without bust darts, you don't have anything to worry about. Just go ahead and draw your slash line. Okay, so for the cowl now you can decide to draw. So if I want to draw my slash line now, I can start off from here. Now as you so desire. Okay, so I can then from here And then if I want to get to the armhole, I hope you can see what I'm doing. Okay, so just draw your slash lines the way you want it. So, but I'll be using my ruler to draw. Now you can decide to measure, but there is actually no need. But if you want to measure, you can measure the distance. At the end of the day, everything will fall into the cowl, so you won't even know the distance. Okay, so you extend it. So I'll draw another slash line. I'm not measuring. You can measure. But my shoulder is altered already. It's distorted. So it's fine. It's a cow, right? It's fine. You can leave it like this. So what I'll do now is to pin. So like I said, if you said you want to measure, you can decide to measure. But this is the amount of fullness I want. Okay, so I can still spread more. Okay, so you can see it has entered. So this is what I have. So everything is still intact. You can see this is where my shoulder ends. Please, I need you to get this part very, very well. This is where my shoulder ends. Okay, so I'll draw a straight line like this. So don't bother about the neck. So you can see our neck is altered. Don't bother. So what you need to do is to, I'll draw a straight line like this. Okay, so this is what I have. And then when I'm cutting, I'll cut my shoulder out. Okay, if you want to add more slash line, you can add. Okay, so it's up to you to do whatever you want to do. Okay, so the more slash lines you add, the more curvier, the more it becomes very, very curvy. Okay, so it depends on how full you want your cow to be. So this is one way. So what I'll do now, let me bring it down. Okay, so what I'll do now is to, you can see where my ruler is. So okay, let me use my pin to pin it down. So this is the shoulder. See, our shoulder is altered. Our shoulder is still the same, but it's now altered. So you can see it's no longer the way it was at the end of my shoulder. So I will draw a straight line. Okay, so this is where, I know you can't see it, right, because of my chalk. So this is now my, you can see this part now. So this is the part that will form the cowl. Okay, my shoulder. So if you still want to add more cowl, you still want it more, so you can still go further. So you can go further like this, and then maybe you connect it this time to the armhole. Okay, so the more slash lines you create, the more fullness you get. So it depends on what you want. Okay, so you can see, so I'll stop at the tip. You don't cut through, you stop around the tip. So just be careful, except you want a pleat like this, the other one that I showed you first earlier. So you can see now, you can see it's now more curvier. Can you see? So you see, so this is it. So the come lower, the more volume, the more fullness you get. So if you want your bust to be fitted, if you want the bust area to be fitted, be sure not to come towards the bust line. Okay, because I don't mind. Okay, but if I want it to, assume I'm sewing my dart, it's a fitted dress now. I won't, you can see where my dart ends, right? So I'll stop somewhere here. Okay, I can just decide to just do stop only around the shoulder here. I won't come down to the armhole. Okay, but because I'm not, no limit to what you can do. Okay, there's no limit at all, right? So now I'll stop. I'll pin it down. Subscribe to my channel. Please subscribe, leave a thumbs up, give us a thumbs up, leave a comment below. You can ask questions, right? On Facebook also, I have a community, La Ruby Clothiers on Facebook, right? And then follow me on Instagram. You can check out what I've been up to December throughout last year, all the time that was away. You can just peep on my Instagram. I'll connect like so or like this, and I will cut. So now, what I'm supposed to do now, if I cut this way, it means I'm going to cut a separate facing. right, to turn this neckline in, but because I don't want to cut a separate facing, I will be cutting this way. So I want to cut it together with my facing, right? I hope somebody is getting it. Nobody is confused, right? Straightforward. It's nothing serious. But because I don't want any joining at all around this my new neckline, so I will be doing the facing. I'll just cut, I'll extend it just for the facing, right? So that it will fold inside. Okay, I hope you're getting me. So I'm cutting it together with the facing up. Also, still from this point here, from the shoulder tip there, okay? So from this place, I will just come up a B. So I don't this way, okay? So this is how I'm cutting now. So let me cut it. Don't mind your cow also getting to your waist. You can slash your waist. Now let me show you. I'm not doing that, but I just want to show you. Okay, so there's no limit to what you can do. So everything, you can see I've gone up also. So this is your waistline, so your cow will also get to your waist, okay? So it's up to you what you want, right? So I'm not doing that. I'm just showing you that you can, your cow can get to your waistline, okay? So it will still be fitted. This side will be firm on your waist, but this side will be full, okay? You have fullness around the waist area, okay? So this is what I'm doing. So I will just cut now. I'm cutting. You can see that this is my original neckline, and then this is my facing. So I'm cutting. I've added all my seam allowance. This fabric is stretchy. You can see how stretchy it is. So that is why I added 1 inch allowance. So this is my shoulder. By the time I join the shoulder to the back, everything will fall inside, okay? So this is what I have. So I'll notch the hip, I'll notch the waist just for me, so that when I'm sewing, I know which part is the waist, I know which part is the hip. So the back is, your back is normal. I remove the dart, okay? I remove the waist dart. So my neck is 1 inch. Your back will be the same. I'm not doing any cow except you want to do a cow around the back. So, but I'm not doing. So the opening in the front is enough, and you can see the back. There's no zip allowance. So center back, and then this is it. Okay, no zip at the back. So make sure it's your back is also unfold. Okay. Yeah. So guys, this is the back. Okay, so I've already cut it out, and I'm notching the waistline for easy identification when sewing. Okay, so this is the back. Will you be able to replicate any of these ties? Please tag me on Instagram, or you can share the picture also on Facebook, on our Facebook community, La Ruby Clothier. You can just share it there. Okay, so we can see and appreciate you, right? So let me quickly show you how to join the back and the front. So for the back, I'll be cutting a facing, okay? So maybe let me just get a little fabric for the back, okay? So let me use this. For the back. So let me end it around. So for the armhole, right, I'll be using bias to finish it, okay? If the facing was long enough, I would have cut the facing for. Alright, but you can also finish it with bias. So this is after pinning now. So this is what you have. So this is the cow. You can see the front. You can see how, that is why you don't need zip, okay? So your head can go through this. No matter how big your head is, it should fit, okay? And all right, this is the cow. So this is, I folded the edge, okay? so you can pull it inside. So you can also, if you have a two-way fabric, you can decide to leave it this way, okay? So but mine is not two-way, so this is it. So yours now is to style it. You are to style it the way you want, okay? So don't mind this. I saw there's a joining there, so I just decided to use this trimming to finish it up, to close it. So like I said, it's a stay-at-home dress. I just used it to illustrate this tutorial. So thank you. I hope you subscribe and like this video.